Hello, my name's Henry Lukas. I'm the education director at the Spellman Museum of Stamps and Postal History, located on the campus of Regis College in Weston. And our purpose of our program, our monthly program, is to kind of tie in the study of stamps with the study of history. We encourage young people, old people, everybody, to collect stamps for many reasons. One of them being it does connect history events with the stamps. And what we're going to do on this show today is connect events that have happened in the month of August with the event that has been commemorated on stamps, plus also some other holidays related to August and stamps. But let's get started. You should be aware, if you're looking for things to celebrate this month, August is National Catfish Month. And the stamp you're seeing is catfish from the country of Sweden. August is also National Eye Exam Month, which has an interesting connection to one of our collection albums. This is an album of over 1,400 postage stamps from around the world, each stamp featuring a man or a woman wearing eyeglasses. It was put together over a number of years by the wife of a man who gave many eye exams, an optometrist down in Florida, and it actually is now in the Guinness Book of World Records as the largest album with eyeglasses on stamps. And since it's the summertime, we've had strawberries. Last month we mentioned blueberries. This month it's National Peach Month. And of course we associate peaches mostly with the state of Georgia, and it's a great symbol. Also, if you're romantic, this is the perfect month for you. This is Romance Awareness Month, and the post office almost every year has put out love stamps around Valentine's Day, but they're just as good here in July. And these are just two examples of the love stamp. The second one here is actually kind of interesting because as you're driving down the Southeast Expressway through Dorchester, take a look at the gas tank that's over on by the water, and you'll see a slight similarity between this postage stamp and the gas tank. Turns out Sister Coretta Kent, an artist, she was a nun who left the sisterhood, but she then was asked to design this love stamp way back in 1982, and one of the most popular. Although, just like her gas tank, this stamp caused a little controversy. Some people thought it was a little too simple for a postage stamp. And if you really want to be romantic, when you send a letter to your loved one, put the stamp upside down, because that has been a symbol over the years on letters. A stamp upside down means I love you. Two other things happening this month. This is Water Quality Month, so obviously water being very important, especially with the drought that we're having. So these stamps celebrate water quality. And the last thing happening this month, and it's something everybody should do, it's National Picnic Month. And you'll see a stamp. This is a nice stamp, I believe. It's from France. So the other thing happening in August we like to do, connect with history, and that is birthdays. Lots of birthdays being celebrated in August of famous people. The first one on August 1st, the famous author, born out in Pittsfield and lived in New Bedford, and that's Herman Melville. And we have two stamps, one honoring him, and then one honoring his most famous work, Moby Dick. Speaking of Moby Dick, you may or may not know, if you're a Starbucks coffee fan, that the name Starbucks actually comes from the Moby Dick novel. Starbuck was the first mate on the ship. August 4th, we celebrate the birthday of Louis Armstrong, born in 1901. And interestingly, somebody put together a collection for us of people, airports that have been named after famous people, those people are also on stamps. Total comes to about 29. Louis Armstrong is one of them. The airport in New Orleans is named after Louis Armstrong. Also born on August 4th was Raoul Wallenberg, a name that's not too familiar to people, but very well known for helping free many Jews during World War II from Hungary, somewhat similar to Schindler's List. Unfortunately, he was arrested by the Russians after World War II, disappeared, and we didn't quite ever know what happened to him. But August 4th is his birthday. And August 4th, Barack Obama's birthday. We wish him happy birthday. We have a couple of stamps featuring Obama. Of course, he's not on an American stamp because I think, as you may know, we only put dead people on our American stamps. So hopefully he'll have to wait a number of years before he gets honored. But you can see that he is on a Liberian stamp, and Liberia has a connection to U.S. history. Many freed slaves were sent back to Africa in the 1830s. In fact, they named their capital after our president, James Monroe. For the medicine world, we celebrate August 6th, which is Alexander Fleming's birthday, born in 1881. August 7th is a birthday for Ralph Bunche. He was born in 1904, and he is one of the many Americans who received the Nobel Peace Prize for his work in the late 1940s, bringing peace to the Middle East shortly after Israel was created as a country. Another birthday is August 8th, and a man who is associated with exploration, Matthew Henson, African-American, born in 1866. And in 1909, he and Admiral Perry headed up to the North Pole and finally discovered it right at the spot where the pole is. And he's honored along with a bunch of other Arctic explorers. So that's August 8th for Matt Henson. One of our presidents, we can celebrate his birthday. Herbert Hoover was born on August 10th in 1874. Kind of a president who doesn't get too much recognition because he obviously was president at the start of the Depression. But he is also well known for bringing much relief to Europe after World War I, saving thousands of people from starvation. August 13th, a very famous filmmaker and television programmer, Alfred Hitchcock, born in 1889. And if you take a close look at that stamp, and if you look up in the corner, you'll see his profile. And if you have that stamp, that's one of the few stamps that has a hole in it. That profile you can see right through. Also, August 13th is Fidel Castro's birthday, born in 1927. And since he's not an American and not an American stamp, he can get his face on many, many stamps. Another leader of a country, August 15th, 1769, Napoleon is born, featured on a number of French stamps. August 17th, for those of you who grew up in the 50s, you all remember Davy Crockett, born in 1786, born on a mountaintop in Tennessee, if you remember that song from the Walt Disney TV show. And he died at the Alamo, fighting the Mexicans and Santa Ana. And he's honored on a stamp himself, and then the Alamo is also featured on several stamps. Also, a little before that time, born in 1774, half of the Lewis and Clark team, Meriwether Lewis. And he and his partner, as well as Sacagawea, have been honored on several stamps. If you're taking an airplane ride this summer, think of Orville Wright. You can celebrate his birthday on August 19th. Another president born in August is Benjamin Harris in 1883. And this is what I'm showing you is what's called a first day cover. Every stamp has a birthday, and it's put on an envelope and canceled with the first day cover issue. Hawaii, they can wish them a happy birthday this month. In 1959, on August 21st, President Eisenhower signed Hawaii into statehood. Claude Debussy, the French composer, born in 1862 on August 22nd. Also in the musical world, Leonard Bernstein was born on August 25th, 1918. The stamp has a little interesting history. It was one of the last stamps that you had to lick to put on an envelope. After this stamp, almost all stamps became self-adhesive. Another president's birthday, LBJ, born in 1908 on August 27th. And if you come to the museum and take a look at our president's stamps, I believe the Johnson stamp is one of the biggest stamps the post office has ever made, most appropriate for a man from Texas. The same day, Mother Teresa was born, and she's been honored on a number of stamps, including the United States. Oliver Wendell Holmes was born on August 29th in 1809. One of the things he's famous for, besides being a justice, and that is he saved Old Ironsides, the USS Constitution, from being pretty much torn down in the 1830s. He wrote a very famous poem, and we can thank him for still having Old Ironsides in the Boston Harbor. And last birthday, August 30th, Mary Shelley, born on that day, and most famous for Frankenstein. And that's a stamp that actually was issued in a Halloween series. Two sad deaths, two iconic figures died in August. On August 5th, Marilyn Monroe died in 1962. And August 16th, sadly, Elvis has left the building, August 16th, 1977. Oh, and we had president's birthdays, but we also have a president's death this month. August 2nd, in 1923, President Harding suddenly died. And these two stamps, you'll notice, one is black in honor, in memory of his death. And sometimes when people come to the museum and they see a 1.5 cent stamp, they figure, what was that stamp used for? And for those of you old enough to remember, you used to be able to send your Christmas cards. Instead of 3 cents, you sent them for 1.5 cents if you didn't seal the envelope. So those are our birthdays, and we have some other events that happened in this month. August 1st, 1944 is the last entry in Anne Frank's diary, last thing she wrote before the Germans found her hidden away in her upper apartment in Amsterdam. And August 3rd, Christopher Columbus sets out to discover the New World. And his stamp that you're seeing is part of a commemorative series that was issued in 1893, celebrating the anniversary of Columbus arriving in America. Interestingly, this was the first set of commemorative stamps issued by the post office. Nelson Mandela was arrested on August 5th, 1962, and stayed in jail until 1990, when he was released. And he was president of South Africa from 94 to 99. August 6th is the anniversary of Hiroshima. Interestingly, the stamp you're looking at never got issued. It was going to be issued, and there was protest from the Japanese government of putting the atomic bomb on that series stamp. So the stamp was designed, but never printed. It was replaced by another stamp. I also want to mention that a certain stamp has been in the news this week. It's a stamp that was issued in 1991 featuring the planet Pluto, and it was actually put on the rocket ship that went to explore Pluto, which has finally gotten to that planet. And the stamp has actually traveled 3,262,723,132 miles. It was put in the Guinness Book of World Record as the postage stamp that has traveled the farthest. So that's our history and stamps for August. A couple of other things I'd like to mention. If you enjoy this type of connection with history, we're on the screen, you'll see a website where that every day connects a stamp with a historic event of that day. So it's kind of fun to watch that. If you have any questions about the museum, our email is on the screen. And again, as we said last month, mention that you saw the show and you'll get a discount on admissions. In the month of August, we're open Thursday, Friday, and Saturday until from 12 to 5. And on Sunday, August 14th, we will be open for our stamp show from 10 to 3. And that Sunday is free admission to the show as well as to all the galleries. So again, we hope we can get you over here to visit the museum. And we also offer programs for elementary schools, for Boy Scouts and Girl Scouts, senior citizens, public libraries. We love to talk about stamps, and we're happy to share that with people. So again, thank you for watching, and we welcome any comments about our show. Thank you very much.